This is example one of lesson 3.4, solving subtraction equations. And what I have here are a couple of subtraction equations. Now you'll remember from the video on lesson on solving addition equations, a couple of things. One, equations are balance. Equations have the same amount on one side as they do on the other. If you have an equal sign, you know that if you put this much on a balance scale and this much on a balance scale, they're going to be at the same thing. If there's an equal sign between them, you have perfect balance. Your goal is to maintain the balance while also solving for the variable. Your goal is to get the variable by itself, because the only way to know what the variable is to get it by itself. And we do that by using inverse equations, inverse operations, such as the opposite of addition is subtraction, and the opposite of multiplication is division. When we are solving an expression, an equation, like y minus 3 equals 14, we have a subtraction problem here. So we're going to use the inverse operation, which is addition. We are going to be adding to solve subtraction. What I have here, get some pen going, pen, thank you. We have y minus 3 equals 14. Our goal is to get the y by itself, so we need to get rid of the 3. The 3 is being subtracted, so in order to get rid of it, we need to do the opposite thing. So we're going to add. We're going to add 3 here. This will cancel each other out. This is plus 3 minus 3, or minus 3 plus 3. Gets us to 0. What we do to one side of the equation, just like when we were doing fractions, is what we have to do to the other. So if we're going to add 3 to this side, we need to add 3 to this side. So these two things cancel out, bam, and I'm left with just y on this side, equals 14 plus 3 is 17, and we check our answer. Just like we did in 3.1, we're going to see, is 17 the solution? 17 minus 3 equals 14, question mark? Well, 17, 16, 15, 14. Yep. Yes. Our solution is correct. Let's check another one. 52 equals x minus 7. 52 equals x minus 7. On one side of our balance scale, we have 52. On the other side of our balance scale, we have x minus 7. So we want to get the x by itself so we can find x. In order to get the x by itself, we need to get rid of this minus 7. How are we going to get rid of the minus 7? We need to undo that subtraction. How do we undo subtraction? I'm trying to erase that little thing without erasing anything else. How do we undo subtraction? By adding. So we're going to add 7 to both sides, because what I do to one side, I have to do to the other. These two things cancel out. Minus 7 plus 7 gets me 0. So I'm left with just x on this side, which is what I want. And 52 plus 7 equals 59. So let's check our answer to see if 59 is the solution. 59 equals x, that's not what I wanted to do. 52 equals 59, plugging in this value for x, minus 7. 59 minus 7, 59, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 7, 52, we're good, correct. 59 is in fact our, is in fact our solution. Let's do one more. M minus 6 and 1 half equals 2. So, in order to solve this, we need to get the M by itself. How do we get the M by itself? By getting rid of this 6 and a half. How are we going to get rid of it? We're going to undo what's being done to it. It's being subtracted, so we're going to add. And we're going to add it to itself, 6 and 1 half. And because what we do to one side, we have to do to the other. Whoops, don't write an equal sign there. Just plus 6 and 1 half. And then below that, this is what I'm doing to it. This is what I've done to it. And this is my next step. M equals 6 and a half plus 2 is 8 and 1 half. Let's check our answer. 8 and 1 half minus 6 and 1 half equals 2. Well, the 1 half minus 1 half is 0, and 8 minus 6 is 2. So m equals 8 and a half. Now, if you're asking yourself, why do you write that step in the middle when you can just do it in your head? Okay, that's a good question. Why do you write this stuff down? Again, it's a process thing. When you're getting more complicated questions, say you're doing, 3x minus 7 equals, come on, give me my 7, please. Equals 21 plus 4x. Now, you can't really do that in your head. You're still going to do the same steps. So I'm going to add 7 plus 7. That gives me 3x on this side and 28 plus 4x on this side. This is not a good equation because it's going to get me into negatives. That's what I get for pulling one out of my head. And then I'm going to subtract 4x over here, move that over there, minus 4x. And that's going to get me negative x equals 28. And then I need to divide by negative 1. And I'm going to get x equals negative 28. And then I can go back in and plug it in. But I write my steps. I write down what I did each step so I can go back in if I messed up somewhere and go, whoa, okay, I wasn't supposed to do that. I should have done this first. It's a way of checking your work, showing you're working out so that we can see where you went wrong if you went wrong. Now, no, it doesn't make a lot of sense to do it on one-step equations, but again, not the point. You still practice dribbling even though you know how to dribble. Professional basketball players still practice passing because it's important to practice. Okay? It's important to practice even the easy stuff.